अस्त्युत्तरस्यां दिशिदेवतात्मा हिमालयो नाम नगाधिराजः पूर्वापरौ तोयनिधिवगाह्य स्थितः पृथिव्या इव मानदण्डः। द श्लोक वी लास्ट सॉ वाज अबाउट हर द नवरोम राजी तस्याः प्रविष्टा नत नाभिरंध्रम राराज तन्वी नवरोमराजिः नीवीम अतिक्रम्य सितेतरस्य तन्मेखला मध्यमणेः इव अर्चिः। He described her Romaraji, and now we are going to move on to her Madhyabhagam, which is the waist portion. So Madhyesa Vedi Vilagna Madhya, Madhyenasa Vedi Vilagna Madhya, Valitrayam Charu Babhara Bala, Arohanartham Navayavvanasya कामेन सोपानमिव प्रयुक्तम्। सा बाला मध्येन मध्येन मध्यभागेन विद हर वेस्ट सा बाला शी देयर इज अनदर एडजेक्टिव फॉर हर व्हिच इज वेदी विलग्न मध्य विलग्न इज कृशा वेदी वेदी ही इव विलग्न मध्यासा हर वेस्ट वाज वेरी स्लिम विलग्न मध्य like a vedi vedi it's the yaga platform no the where the yaga homa is present it is as you go it is like there are three steps and the middle portion is very thin right so tadrisham tasyah madhyabhagah asit tadrishah so vedi vilagna madhyasa tadrisha madhyena krishena madhyena valitrayam charu valitrayam babhara she had a very beautiful three lines that were there three folds or three lines that were present it is valinam trayam there were three let's say I don't know how you he says folds of skin but I think it's more like three lines that are visible like for sometimes some people there might be lines on the forehead for some people for men for women it is there on the waist so valitrayam charu valitrayam babhara she possessed she had beautiful three lines on her waist now these three lines were looking like a sopanam like a staircase for yavvanam nava yavvanasya aarohanartham kamena nirmitam kamena prayuktam sopanam iva aasitu tat valitrayam It was as if Kama Manmatha had decided to build a flight of stairs for Yavvanam to start ascending. Okay, so the Vedi upamanam is also very appropriate there because the Vedi has three steps there, right? You know, in a way, Homa Yaga sacrifice, you will have three steps which are built, and then inside there is a Agni. So, in the same way, her Madhyabhagam was also like that, and these three were like steps for Nava Yavvanasya Arohanartham. She has just entered into Yavvanam. And as Yavvana has to ascend in her body, it slowly moved from her hips to her waist, then to her breast, and then to her face. That's how it is going to ascend and show itself in her body. So, Nava Yavvanasya Arohanartham Kamena Manmathena Prayuktam Nirmitam Sopanamiva Vanitrayam Babhara She had these three lines on her waist. Okay, so Vyakhyanam Valitrayam Varnayati Sa Bala Madhyena Valitrayam Babhara Iti Sa Parvati Bala Ityanena Valitraya Abhivyaktehe Kalaprapthihi Dvanyate She's just at the point where, at the stage where these three skin, the three lines are starting to show on her waist. तर्हि वलित्रयस्य अभिव्यक्तेः उचितः कालः प्राप्तः इति वर्णयितुम् अत्र बाला सा वलित्रयं बभार इति उक्तम् सो मध्येन वलित्रयं बभार वलित्रयं उत्प्रेक्षते नवयौवनस्य आरोहणार्थं कामेन प्रयुक्तं सोपानम् इव नवयौवनस्य नव अभिनवयौवनस्य अत एव आरोहणे सोपान अपेक्षा वर्तते it just doesn't. So she is also a bala. She is a mugdha naika. She is not a proudha naika. For her to just appear as a youthful lady, we are describing her from her childhood, and she has just entered. So you have to show that progress here, and she's not a proudha who is very experienced in these matters of love, because she is described as bala. Nava yavvanam idanimeva arohati tasyaha sharire tasyaha dehe. One teacher of mine would say, you never use shariram for devata, because shariram is shiryate iti shariram. You say dehaha dihyate, it's dedipyate. And it's growing. So you use dehaha and not shariram for, we can use jivasya shariram.
Yeah, so anya mekaha api tadeva uktavan. Katamasti iti prichati chet. Dehaha asiti danim shariram abhavat.
Oh, so nice. Correct. But for want of a word, and suddenly, you know, shariram is a word that quickly comes to our mind more than deha. I don't know why. It's a good thing also to remind us constantly, shiryate iti. Adayeva arohane sopana apeksha vartate. Navayavvanam iti karanat arohanartham tatra sopanam avashyakam. Arohanartham stana vadanadi pradesha praptyartham ityartha. In order to ascend in her body, he needs yavvana, youth needs that staircase. Okay. Atra tadrisha valitraya rupa sopana nirmana karma tat shilpinam kalpayati kamena iti. Nahi anyena nirmite tadrisham charutvam sambhavati iti bhavaha. If it was Brahma who had created all this, see, Brahma was responsible for creating her body, that's all. He had left it. His creation is over there. But then to make that yavvanam blossom in her, you need the hand of Manmatha. Without Manmatha, you cannot make nava yavvanam come into her body. So anyena kenapi nirmite sati etadrisham charutvam na bhavet iti karanat kamena eva prayuktam valitrayam sopanam iva. So kamena that shilpi is valitraya rupa sopanam. For such a valitrayam, that is a sopanam, it is like a staircase. In order to create such a staircase, you need an expert, which can only be Manmatha. Because Manmatha, I think in the fifth sargalia, third, he also says, right, tambiksha sarvavayavana vadyam. 1 minute. I'll just take that. Tamvikya sarvamayavana vadyam raterapi hripadam adadhanam jitendriye shulini pushpachapaha svakarya siddhim punarashasamse. He has to ensure that he can use her as a backup plan for him to win over Shiva. So everything that yavvanam is going to be useful for him to win over Shiva, and so he takes care even in the beginning stage. And so yavvanasya arohanartham sopanam atra kamena swayameva kritam nirmanam kritam atra madanasya sopana kartritva utprekshaya tasya prageva agatya yavvana agamana pratikshanam dhanyate. So he must have already come there even as a young lady, even before she had entered into the youth, or just as she was entering into the youth, she was already beautiful to look at and very attractive. So manmathaha tatra purvameva asit agatya pratikshanam akarot yavvanasya agamanartham tadanantaram yavvanasya arohanartham sopanam nirmitam. Right? Sopana kartritva utprekshaya tasya prageva agatya. He had already arrived. And yavvana agamana pratikshanam. He was waiting for yavvanam to come into her body. Tena cha devyaha charutva atishayaha. Balyavasthayam api charutva atishayaha asti. Atratu yavvanaya avasthayam tu kimuta. You know, and, yeah, we don't need to say it separately that she was more beautiful during yavvana. Avalagnam varnayati. Avalagnam. Kimartham avalagnam? मध्ये अवलग् मध्येन अवलग्नेन अवलग्नम इज मध्यभागम ओके या
सो नवयौवना इज इमेजिन्ड टू हैव बिल्ट द स्टेप्स
नो नो मन्मथा हैज बिल्ट द स्टेप्स फॉर यौवनम टू असेंड
सो बट इन द श्लोक इज नवयौवनेन
नवयौवनस्य आरोहणार्थमेव खलु आरोहणार्थं नवयौवनस्य कामेन सोपानमिव प्रयुक्तम् ओ मल्लिनाथ हैज अ डिफरेंट रीडिंग आरोहणार्थं नवयौवनेन कामस्य सोपानम् इव प्रयुक्तम् इति वा
तथा एव अस्ति वा पुस्तके
अयो डजंट मेक सेंस देयर
That's what I was wondering. Okay, Navayovanasya Kamena. Okay, this is better. Okay.
This is a better reading, no? Navayovanam eva tatra arohanam karoti. Kamaha natu arohanam karoti. Kamaha purvam eva vidyate tatra. Why do we have to bring kama? I would prefer it this way. For the gradual youth to blossom in her, he needs a staircase. Yavanam needs a staircase. And that was built by Kama.
So, okay. So the utpreksha would be in that Kama Deva is if you take Kama as a devata, then that is a person. So yes. So that means there is not you can't say it's utpreksha, right?
No, Kamena nirmitam iti that part is utpreksha. Where is Manmatha coming and constructing a staircase on her? That part is actually an utpreksha. And sopanam iva is just, even if you take sopanam iva asti valitrayam, that can be an upama. But then he is using a visheshana for that sopanam as kamena yavvanasya arohanartham tatra heturapi utprekshitam. Utprekshitam. Right? The hetu is arohanartham in order for youth to walk up. Youth is not going to walk up. So that is utpreksha. Kamena prayuktam sopanam. Kamena nirmitam sopanam. Kama, that is also utpreksha.
Oh, okay. Got it. So double utpreksha. Very nice. So what is the word for, like, you know, sometimes there'll be a series of upamas and metaphors in one bunch. There's a word for that, right?
Mala upama.
Oh, mala. Oh, okay.
That is
there'll be
you can't say mala utpreksha here.
You can't say that. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Mala upama is where you have one upameya and you have several upamanams
for the same
with different samana dharma. Or there can be the same samana dharma also. Then it is a mala upama.
Okay, got it.
Utpreksha here, you're actually fancying different things. You're not, see, if you look at the shlokam in Kuvalayananda, Ankam kepi sashankire jalanidhev pankam paremenire. There are a series of utpreksha, but it is of that same, you can probably call it as mala utpreksha because you're only using the kalankam and fancying that kalankam. Have you heard of that shloka?
No, I have not.
Ankankepi shashankire jalanidhehe pankampare menire. Jalanidhehe uttitaha chandraha. Right? He came from samudra mathanam. Tasmat antaha jalanidhehe, on the floor of the ocean floor, you have a lot of pankam there. And it is as if that pankam has come onto this chandra and that is that kalankam. अंकंकेपि शशंकिरे जलनिधे पंकं परे मेरिदे सारंगं कतिचित् संजगदिरे सारंगं कतिचित् संजगदिरे केचित् तु तत्र सारंगः अस्ति इति वदन्ति इट इज अ डियर सम से दैट देयर इज अ डियर एंड दैट इज द कलंकम ऑन द मून सारंगं कतिचित् संजगदिरे भूच्छायम ऐच्छन् परे भूमेहे छाया तत्र इट हैज फॉलन देयर दैट इज व्हाई इट इज अंकम भूच्छायम ऐच्छन् परे इंदोर्यत् दलितेन्द्र नील शकल श्यामंदरी दृश्यते तत्सांद्रम निशि पीतम अंध तमसम कुक्षिस्थम आचक्ष्महे बट व्हाट आई से अपय दीक्षितर्स ओन दिस थिंग इज आचक्ष्महे सी द होल नाइट ही इज ड्रिंकिंग दैट तमस night, the darkness that is there during the night, that has gone and stuck in his stomach. That is what we are seeing.
That is Utpreksha again.
Fully, yes. All of it are Utpreksha.
That's amazing.
Oh, beautiful shloka.
You have taught the whole thing, right? Kovalyananda?
The Kovalyananda, yes.
It's there, okay.
It's there in Tamil.
Yeah. Oh, it's in Tamil, okay.
Yeah.
Maybe you have to teach it in English for us.
Maybe.
Yes, we need it.
Yes, we need it.
Slowly, one by one. Put it in a bucket list, we'll do it. If I say anything, see, he would always say, if I say anything is good, then it's going to come back on me. Arohanartham, Navayavvanasya Kamena Sopanamiva Prayuktam. Where were we in this? Atra Madanasya Sopanakattuka Utprekshaya Tasya Prageva Agatya Yavvana Agamana Pratikshanam Dunyate Tena Devyaha Charutva Atishayaha Vediriva Vilagna Madhya. This is an upama here. This is a luktopama. Vedihi Iva Vilagnaha Madhyabhagaha Yasyaha Sa. So Vedihi is a Yajnashala. Yajnashalayam Dviangula Nikataha Bhubhagaha Dvi Angula Matram. Dvi Angulam is a measure for two angula. Nikataha, it has been dug up, and that part is called Madhyabhagam or a Vedi. It's the platform where you perform the Yaga. Vilagati hrasati iti vilagnam krisham ityarthaha. Hrasati, that is, it becomes less in hrasvaha. No, it comes from there only. Vediriva krishamadhya ityarthaha. Vedyaha krishamadhyatvam tu prasiddham iti uktam. I was really thinking about why it should be, you know, madhyabhagam is like a Vedi. I think it's because of those three steps and then the middle portion is smaller. That must be the idea that he had in his mind. So, valitrayasya sopana paramparavat kramena avasthanam tad utprekshaya hetuhu atayeva charu sundaram. So, sopanam iva parampara yatha vidyate tatha valinam trayasyapi parampara vidyate kramena tatra nirmitam. So there is a sequence in which it is also made in a very sequential manner. Those three lines on her skin are also very sequential and symmetrical, just as how a staircase is built. So it is not in a very haphazard manner. Because he is describing Devi, it has to be extremely symmetrical and, you know, even the Januni Suvritte, he used that word for her, that also, right? So the symmetry is very important here. So sopana paramparavat kramena avasthanam atayeva charu. Okay.
So lupta upama nama tatra kim kaha shabdah luptaha katam luptam
iva nasti.
Oh, okay.
Iva has gone into the samasta padam.
Oh.
So you have Vedihi Iva, Vilagna Madhya is Sadharana Dharma, Bala Iti Asti. That is your Upameya. Generally, if it is within the Samasta Padam, you call it as Luptopama, where the Iva Shabda is not there. So Madhyena Sa, Vedi Vilagna Madhya, Varitrayam Charu Babhara Bala, Arohanartham Navayavvanasya Kamena Sopanamiva Prayuttam. After her waist, he describes her breasts here. So, anyonyam utpidayat utpalakshyaha stanadvayam pandu tatha pravruddham madhye yatha shyama mukhasya tasya mrinala sutrantaram api alabhyam. Yatha shyama mukhasya tasya madhye stanadvayasya madhye mrinala sutrantaram mrinala sutrasya antaram avakashaha api alabhyam. Avakashaha api nasthi tatha pravruddham anyonyam utpidayat tasyaha stanadvayam asit utpalakshyaha. She had beautiful eyes like lily. Utpala akshi utpale utpalasya akshini iva akshini yasyaha sa tadrisham. So utpalakshyaha tasyaha anyonyam utpidayat stanadvayam. Stanadvayam, her two breasts were anyonyam utpidayat, they were pressing against each other. Pandu. They were also very whitish in color. And Pravriddham, they were well built and rounded also. Shyama Mukhasya Tasya, the top portion was Shyama, very Krishna, Krishna Varnena Yuktaha, Yuktam Stanadvayam. Madhye, Ubhayor Madhye, Stanayoho Madhye, Atra Mrinala Sutrasya Antaramapi Na Labhyam. There was not even a space for even a little lotus fiber to pass through. Tadrisham asit. So Mrinala Sutram here is lotus fiber. Even a lotus fiber could not find a space in between. Antaram. Okay. So Stanadvayam Varnayati, Utpalakshyaha Stanadvayam Tatha Pravruddham. Stanadvaya Utpalakshyaha Utpale Kuvalaye Iva Akshini Yasyahasa. So Kuvalayasya Kuvalaye Iva Akshini. This is also Luptopama for you here. Right, Utpalamiva Akshini. Stanadvayam Stanayoho Kuchayoho Dvandvam Tatha Vakshyamana Prakarena Pravruddham Prakarshena Vruddham Paripushtam Asit. It was slowly growing because the Yavvanam had just started to blossom, and so from her waist it moved on to the upper portion of the body. So Tatha Pravruddham Yatha Shyama Mukhasya Tasya Madhye Mrinala Sutrantaramapi Alabhyam. Tasya stanadvayasya madhye antarale mrinala sutrantaram mrinalasya sutram tasya antaram ityukte avakashah. Not even the space for a sutram. Kim punaha anya sutranam antaram. What to say of other threads? Mrinala sutram is something which is very thin and very soft too. Even that could not did not have any space there. Alabhyam.
Can you say that it's arthapati? Like, because you're getting something else.
Yeah, kimuta. Correct. Yeah, kaimutika nyayam. Yatra yatra kaimutika nyayam vartate tatra tu arthapatireva. You can have that. Yeah. Kiyad antaram. So now everybody is becoming an expert. I have to brush up my alankara.
I'm learning. This is, because I missed out. I felt like we should have learned Kuvalaya Ananda. But yeah. I learned, I got the knowledge only after I finished the Kavya class. Yeah, it's like I feel like I missed out. That's why I'm desperately trying to catch up on
spam. No, good. See, this is where you apply. You half the time, you know, you just read Kuvalaya Ananda separately and let it go, and then you don't apply it in Kavyam, then it doesn't make sense. You slowly try to find out like this. It's good. Kiyad antaram anayoho iti avagantum pariksha prasange tan madhyam niyamanasya visatantoho antaramapi yatha parikshaka janena na labhyam tatha pravruddham asit. This is something, if someone wants to test what is the space between the two, then if you take a mrinala sutram, tatsyapi antaram na vidyate tatha pravruddham asit. Okay. So there is a Nyunapada Dosham and all. I won't go into that because there is another Pathabeda which he uses. Does Mallinatha use this Patham? Mrinala Sutrena Padam Nalabdham Iti.
No.
Okay. No. Then it's fine. Anyonyam Utpidayat. Anyonyam Parasparam Utpidayat. Uthaya Pidayat. Atayeva Charu Sundaram Pandu Api Asti. This is because of Yavvanam that it is like that. Okay. So Anyonyam Utpidayat Utpalakshyaha Stanadvayam Pandu Tatha Pravruddham Madhye Yatha Shyama Mukhasya Tasya Mrinala Sutrantaramapi Alabhyam. Right. The next one is Bahu Shirisha Maladhika Saukumaryau Bahu tadiyo itime pratarkaha parajitena api kritau shaharasya yaukanthapashau makaradhvajena shirisha mala adhika saukumaryo shirisha mala. So both her arms, now he describes her bahu, both tadiyo bahu, both her arms are saukumaryo, are even more tender than a shirisha mala. Shirisha Pushpamna, Shirisha Mala. It's appropriate that he uses this word Shirisha here. when Parvati decides to go for tapas, Shirisha Pushpam Napunav Patatrinaha. Padam Saheta Brahmarasya Pelavam Shirisha Pushpam Napunav Patatrinaha. You know, Shirisha Pushpam is something which is so soft, it cannot stand even the legs of a Brahmara, a bee. So the bee, if it comes and lands itself, it is going to fade off. So her bahu is so tender. And when she goes to tapas, her mother or her father, someone will ask her, you know, why are you undertaking this tapas? Shirisha Pushpam na punav patatrinaha. It can probably... what is the first line? I keep forgetting that. Brahmarasya pelavam. It can only take the feet of a brahmarasya, but not that of a bird. If a bird comes and stands on the flower, it cannot take it, seems. So your body cannot take the hardships of a penance. Why do you have to go there? So this everything is actually a prelude to that fifth sarga. There is it is not just a simple description that he gives. Every single shloka has an effect either in the third sarga where she meets Shiva, or in the fifth sarga where she does tapas, or in the seventh where the Kalyanam happens. So there is no wastefulness in Kalidasa's Kavyam.
So there is like a reflection of these shlokas in a different way in different sargas.
Yeah, he would use that same upamanam, or in a different manner he would use it for us to, you know, loop it back and understand it in a whole sense. Because a kavyam, if it has to give you rasam, it has to give you in its holistic manner. You can't take just one shloka and look at it, right?
What is the name of this pushpam in in Tamil or in
Tumbappu?
Tumbappu, okay.
Tumba is Kasha Pushpam. Shirisha Pushpam, I have no idea. See, because for instead of pushpam is just one pushpam, whereas the bahu is the entire arm. So it makes more sense to have Shirisha Mala Adhika Saukumaryo. Malayaha api adhika sukumarata vartate bahu bahuho. Iti met pratarkaha. He is only imagining it. See, Kalidasa also, he says, you know, I think it should be like this. I don't know. So Shirisha Mala Adhika Saukumaryo Tadiyo Bahu Iti me pratarkaha. Yau bahu, those two hands were made as kanthapashav for Hara. She hugged him with her two hands and it became a kanthapasham because makaradvajena, parajitena makaradvajena, harasya kanthapashav iva krito. So when you are he is lost here. He lost his body, but then he had to take revenge. So he took revenge by using Parvati's hands as kanthapasha. You actually bind someone and you drag them along that way.
Beautiful discussion. Very, very beautiful.
His imagination is so different, I feel. In Mooka Panchashati, you should look at the way he describes. There he says, very similarly, he says he uses Devi's... Adina, 1 minute. There was one shloka where he talks of Manmatha as the dhivara to take the manasa meenam. Maheshwaram manasa meenam api. Where did I note down? Maheshwaram jatiti manasa meenam amba kamakshi dhairya jaladau nitaram nimagnam. Dhairya jaladau Maheshwaram manasa meenam nimagnam manasa meenam dhivaraha iva eshaha manmathaha. Jalena shrinkhala yati tvad apanga janma. Your apangam is like a jalam. It is like a net. And with that net, Manmatha catches the manas of Shiva, which is like the fish. And that fish is completely immersed in dhairyam. He thinks that he is the greatest of yogi. But then he is caught by Devi's apangam. Such descriptions are very beautiful.
There is one other shloka in Saundara Lahari, right? You know, where they say they he hit the Manmada's dhanu in the eyebrows, actually somewhere in Sandhya. I don't recall the shloka. Where he actually compares the eyebrows to the dhanu.
Yuo bhugne kinchit bhuvana bhaya bhangam vyasarini tvadiyene prabhyam madhukara ruchibhyam dhrutagunam dhanur manye savyetara karik hitam ratipate prakoshte mushta ucha stagayati ni gudantaram ame. Right.
Yeah.
Bhruvo bhugne. Both of your eyebrows are bhugnam. They are a little curved. Bhruvo bhugne kinchit bhuvana bhaya bhanga vyasanini tvadiye netrabhyam madhukara ruchibhyam dhrutagunam. So, tvadiye netrabhyam. See, Manmatha's bow is ikshudandam and the gunam is actually a string of bees. Madhukara mayi pancha vishika. So, his string is only a row of bees which is just standing there. You know, to understand this shloka, the sixth shloka is the best. So, Dhanuf Paushpam, Maurvi Madhukaramayi, Pancha Vishikaha, he only has five bows, Pancha Vishikaha, Vasanta Samantaha. His friend is Vasanta Ritu, which is only there for 2 months. It's not there for a whole year. Vasanta Samantaha, Malaya Marut Ayodhanarataha. His ratham is Malaya Marut, which only blows in one direction. That's all. With all of this as his, sakha, Malayamarud Ayodhanarataha, Tathapi Eka Sarvam Himagirisute Kamapi Kripam, Apangatte Labdva Jagadidam Anango Vijayate. He does not have any Anga. And he is only one person who just wins over the entire world. Tat katham sadhyam iti chet bhruvau bhugne kinchit bhuvana bhayavanga vyasanini tvadiye netrabhyam madhukara ruchibhyam dhritagunam. Both of your eyes are like madhukara and it is like that gunam for the bow. The bow is your brow, eyebrows. Madhukara ruchibhyam dhritagunam dhanur manye savyetara grihitam ratipatehe prakoshte mushta ucha stagayati nigudhantaramame. He just uses that as his bow to win over Shiva. Beautiful. If you go into Saundar Lahari, it's a different world there.
So, Purasmin Shloke, Utpalakshi, Utpala Iva Akshi, there was the Luptopama.
Yeah.
Kanta Eva Pashaha.
I think here Kantasya Pashau Iva. You should take it as Kanta Pashau.
Pasha Eva, okay.
కంఠపాశౌ ఏవ ఇతి రూపకం తత్ర యౌ కంఠ ఆర్ ఇట్ షుడ్ బి నో 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 ఇంద అలంకారం కంఠపాశౌ కృతౌ
కృతౌ
తదీయౌ బాహు కంఠపాశౌ కృతౌ ఇట్ ఇస్ దట్ రూపకత్ కప్రం ఒక అలంకారం వరు ప్రతీపం క్రియా నో నో యా క్రియా సాధనాయ రూపకం క్రియతే ఎత్ర the vishaya vishayinoho aropaha kriyate kaschana kriya sadhanartham. There is an alankara there. After rupakam it will come.
So it's not like bahu eva pashau tatana.
Bahu eva pashau kimartham harasya kantha No. I think you're right. It can just be rupakam. What does he say? I don't. He says vyatireka alankara, but he does not deal with that kantapasha ukrato. I think you can call it as.
Preksha kantapasha ukritau iti na?
Ha, kritau eva. Illa?
So it's like upam, it's like rupakam and utpreksha combo, something like that.
Maybe it's a gamya utpreksha. Ha, me pratarkaha. This is what I think. Then iti me, that is utpreksha.
Okay, me pratarkaha. Okay, tasmat.
See, noonam dhruvam iti manye. Manye, noonam, dhruvam. These are all indications for utpreksha. So iti me tarkaha, that is an indication of utpreksha. Whereas this one, adhika saukumaryo is vyatireka alankara. Shirisha malayaha api adhikam saukumaryam bahvoho vidyateti. There you are saying that the upamanadapi adhikyam upameyasya. Iti karanat vyatireka alankara.
Okay. Got it.
Yeah. Look at the vyakhyanam just a little bit and finish. Bahudvayam varnayati तदीयो बाहु शिरीशमाला अधिक सौकुमार्यो इति मे प्रतर्कः शिरीश पुष्पैः कृता माला शिरीशमाला तदपेक्षया अपि अधिकं सौकुमार्यं सुकुमारत्वं व्ययोः तौ पार्वती भुजयोः सुकुमारत्वं शिरीशमालायाः अपि अधिकतरम् इति वयं मन्यामहे कथम् एवं प्रतर्कः इति अत्राह यौ पराजितेनापि मकरध्वजेन इवन दो मन्मथ वाज डिफीटेड ही स्टिल यूज्ड हर बाहु एज हरस्य कंठपाशौ कृतौ यौ बाहु पराजितेन पराजयं प्राप्तेन विफलीभूत सुकुमारतर पूर्व उपकरणेनापि पूर्वं मन्मथेन तौ बाहु एव उपयुक्तौ He had used those two hands and she had brought a mala to give Shiva. Even though they were present in her before, Shiva still burnt Manmatha and so Manmatha was destroyed. He used those two hands to win over again.
So this is Kavyalingam, right? Then?
Huh? Kavyalingama.
Because there's a Hetu, right?
Where is the Hetu here? Parajitena iti Padartha Kavilingam.
Because now it is Sukumara Taram. Why he's saying the reason? Because Parajitena api Makratvejana. So Katam eva Pratarkaha. He's giving the reason why, right? He's giving the reason why.
For what?
Sukumara Taram.
No. Sukumara Tarena api Purvam Kimapi na Kritam. Adhuna tu tapasaha anantaram kritam. See, even if it was very soft, he couldn't win over. That's all.
Uh-huh.
Is given here. There is no reason for that.
Okay. The reason,
right?
Okay.
So, Kamadevena, harasya, his description of this kantha pashav is so beautiful. Parameshwarasya kanthe pashav svavashi kritya svechaya ततहितः कर्षणार्थं कंटे निक्षिप्तौ पाशौ सी अल्टीमेटली शिवा हैड टू एक्ट ओनली बेस्ड ऑन शक्ति विदाउट शक्ति ही कुडंट एक्ट सो दीस टू बाहु वेर लाइक कंठपाशम फॉर हर टू पुल हिम दिस वे एंड दैट वे इट सीम्स शिव शक्त्या युक्तः एव प्रभवति न तु अन्यथा यः मकरध्वजः पूर्वं दर्पात् देवम् आसाद्य विफलीभूत सुकुमार तर पूर्व उपकरणः जातः दैट सौकुमार्यं वाज एन उपकरणम् इट वाज अ वेपन फॉर हिम इट वाज समथिंग विच ही यूज्ड एज ए सप्लीमेंट उपकरणम् टू ट्राई टू विन द गॉड बट ही हैड अ दर्प ही हैड एन एरोगेंस देन कुर्याम हरस्यापि पिनाकपाणेः धैर्यच्युतिम् இது அது விசேன் தமிழ்ல நுணலும் தன் வாயால் கெடும்பா இந்திரா டிட் நாட் ஈவன் ஆஸ்க் ஹீ ஜஸ்ட் செட் கம் அண்ட் சிட் டவுன் அர்தாசனம் பிரதர்ஷ்ய மன்மதம் அத்த ஆகச்ச இது உக்தவன் தாவதேவ திஸ் ஃபெலோ ஹி வாஸ் சோ பிளீஸ்ட் வென் இந்திரா ஆஸ்க்ட் ஹிம் தட் ஹி ஹிம்செல்ஃப் வாலண்டியர்ட் ஹி சே இஃப் யூ வாண்ட் மீ டு யூ நோ வின் ஓவர் சிவா ஐ வில் டு தட் देवं आसाद्य विफलीभूत सुकुमारतर पूर्व उपकरणः जातः प्रथमं तदनन्तरं सः एव मन्मथः याभ्यां पशुमिव रज्ज्वा this is too much but like the art katti ilukra madri like how you bind an animal and pull it rajwa kante nibadya atmavidheyam chakara manmathah tayoho saukumaryam katham शिरीश कुसुमादिभिः उपमातुं शक्यम् इति भावः अत्र व्यतिरेकः अलङ्कारः
पशुः एव पतिः इति पशुपतिः इति
ओ नूतनः विग्रहवाक्यं करेक्ट् पतिरेव अत्र पशुरिव अभवत् वाह् ऐ लाइक् दिस् वन् शिरीशमाला अधिक सौकुमार्यौ बाहू तदीयौ इति मे प्रतर्कः पराजितेनापि कृतौ हरस्य यौ कंठपाशौ मकरध्वजेन ओके okay.